Hi. Hello, friends. So we're in the thick of the surge of the pandemic right now, and I hope all of you are staying safe. One of the most important aspects of staying safe is using the proper PPE and using it in the proper way. So among the proper PPE, there's a lot of concern with respect to N95. I wanted to bring to attention all of my friends and colleagues that there's a lot of fake N95s floating around. So how do you spot a fake N95? The most important thing that you need to see is that in an original N95 there will always be certain markings, whereas in a fake N95 it will be empty. You can see that there are no markings on this fake N95, right? So the original N95 will have something called an NIOSH mentioned, whereas a fake N95 will have nothing called NIOSH mentioned, and even if it is mentioned, it will be spelled wrong. It might be spelled as NOISH or NOIHS. In addition to that, another important thing that you need to understand is that N95s are made as respirators, and what respirator means that it filters out all the air that you're breathing in and breathing out, so it has to form a tight seal around your face. To form a tight seal, there are two important components that all N95 have to have. And those two important components are, one, it has to have a metal strip. So you can see the metal strip that is there near the nose end of the N95, which is there in the original N95. However, if you see the fake N95, there is no metal strip. You cannot form a tight seal using this mask. The second thing that is important to form a tight seal is you need to have headbands. Okay? So headband means that the band goes all the way around your head, and usually it is of an elastic nature, right? So that is an important thing. Whereas fake N95s, they usually have ear loops. So with a ear loop, it is very difficult to form a tight fit around your nose and mouth. In addition to that, one important thing that you can do is you can go to the CDC website, which will be mentioned in the link, where you can check the approval number. So the approval number will usually have TC in front of it, and that will be followed by certain numbers. So usually two numbers, a letter, and then a four-digit number. Okay. Whereas you can see there are certain fake N95s which have mentioned N95 and which are given some sort of vague approval number below, which I can hardly make out. So in this kind of situation, you can go to the CDC website, or you can go to the website of the manufacturer themselves. So, for example, this N95 claims that it is from Magnum, but if you go to the Magnum website, there is no such N95 mentioned over there. The other thing is, they have mentioned FFP2 SL. So, FFP2 respirators, which is a different way of marking it, has to be red colored headbands, whereas this is blue colored headbands. Blue colored headbands is usually means FFP1. So, there's a lot of discrepancies that you will find in fake N95. So many of us, because we don't know, this is all new to us, the pandemic is new to us, we tend to buy N95s either on third market websites such as Amazon, or we do a Google search and then we go to a website and buy it. So how do you spot if the N95s over there are fake? So important thing is, if there are spelling mistakes in the advertisement of the website, advertisement of the N95 mask, if the email that the seller is using is a free email service, for example, at gmail.com, at yahoo.com, instead of the company name. For example, if this real N95 is being produced by Magnum company, so on the website, the seller should give original email ID, something like contact@magnum.com, right? So that is more likely to be original. If the person has contact@magnum@gmail.com, that's more likely to be a fake N95. In addition to that, if they claim that it is approved for children, then that is also likely to be fake, because there are no N95s which have been approved by NIOSH for children. So that is, in addition to that, if in their advertisement, especially on Amazon, if they say this is legitimate or genuine N95, then it's most likely to be fake, because genuine or legitimate N95 manufacturers or marketers do not advertise it as such. So I hope this information helps you to make a right decision, and you're able to use your N95 properly to keep yourself safe. Bye.